Okay, we are going to attempt to draft a flange, whatever it's called. Honestly, I don't have a lot of experience with this, so I just did a little Google search and I found actually kind of a lot of styles. So I mean, it's kind of cool, sort of unique. So anyways, we're gonna do it. To me, it kind of just looks like a pleat, if you will, almost like in between a pleat and a pin tuck, but it's a little thicker and kind of stylized. It can be straight up and down or kind of at an angle. Oh look, this is the pattern that we're doing. Okay, so that's really what we're doing. It could be kind of a cool for costumes or maybe some new fashion. All righty, so here are instructions from the book. They want us to take our bodice sloper and they want us to move the dart. But you know what? I don't need these sleeves, so I'm just gonna get rid of them for right now. Okay, so usually I do like to rotate the dart by selecting it and then doing a right click to rotate. But what that does, it's gonna leave an empty space. So I actually don't think that's good for like what we're trying to do right now. Cause then we have this empty space and it's a little bit of work to, I mean, I could delete this point, but then I don't have my internal lines. Anyways, I was kind of playing around with it and I'm gonna say edit undo. And I actually think in this case, because we want to keep all that fabric, that we should use the fullness tool instead. So I'm gonna click it one time and we'll start the fullness from the dart point. Now, problem is I'm using kind of like a larger sloper. It's not like the size 6 that the book's probably using. So I have a bigger armhole cutout. So I think to get away, because I think it's gonna give me trouble that it's crossing the pattern. I don't know, let me double check. Oh, maybe not, let's see. Click. Oh yeah, it is letting me, but okay. But I want this internal line to be on my fabric. So I'm gonna go ahead and reshape my armhole and I can always reshape it again later. Let's see here, what's a good tool to use? Should I try this one? Click and okay. That way my line I'm gonna use is actually on the pattern. Okay, so there we go. Step one, transfer the dart to the shoulder tip. Step two, fold our flange with the inside fold toward center front. Okay, so we're basically doing a pleat. So I should turn these to internal lines. So I will switch just to the letter A tool. I'm gonna right click and I'm gonna unlock all the baselines. I'm gonna go ahead and select these two baselines. I'm holding shift. I'll right click and convert them to internal lines. Okay, cool. So I think I also would like to do an internal line right in the middle. So to get to the middle, I could split this line. So I'll say X, right click, uniform split to, that way I don't have to do math. And then I can hit Z and I can make, an internal line by, you know, saying I'm doing a perpendicular line, just say local. I can mess around with the degrees, but it doesn't really matter. I'm just gonna say okay, and then I'm gonna go grab it myself. Whoops, I'm gonna grab just one part of it. So I deselected by clicking the artboard, and I guess I'll grab this shape. Ooh, it's the wrong one. Okay, that's okay, I'll separate them. And I'll just put it up here. So now they're all kind of together. I think this will help me do that pleat fold, which I don't know if you guys remember pleats, but they're just so much fun. Okay, so basically this red line is gonna be the outer line here, okay? So the fabric's basically gonna fold, is this right? Am I thinking about this right? Oh no, I'm wrong. Okay, this line, sorry, I get so confused. This line is going to be right here, the outer fold. So this guy, we need the wrong sides together. And so basically it's like coming like this. Yellow line's gonna come over here. And then the red line's actually gonna have right sides together. Play around with it, think about it. So I'm gonna choose this guy because I want right sides together. It should be a fold line of 360 degrees. And if you don't have that memorized, what I did, I just got a square of fabric and I added an internal line and I played with the fold lines till I remembered that right sides together should be 360. So I'm gonna open up that property editor, fold, let's just do 360. I'm gonna say fold rendering, cool. And then the other guy, I'm gonna do the opposite at zero because it's wrong sides together. And I'll also check the fold rendering. Okay. Cool. So I also need to sew this guy together. I think what might be easiest is to just delete the shoulder stitches for now. I just kind of feel like maybe they'll get in the way. Maybe they won't. Well, let me see. What's this guy? I'm just going to delete them and we can deal with them later. And because I'm deleting them, I'm going to freeze the back piece so it doesn't fall off. Because it's, I just want to be real careful folding this front guy. Okie dokie. So I do want this pleat folded together. So my little tag lines are going to be close to each other like that. And hopefully this will work out. I might need to reset it. Or maybe I just go for it. I'm not sure. Zoom in here. I'm like, I probably should reset it, don't you think? Let's see. Yeah, why not? Okay, so I'm gonna select this guy, right click, reset 3D. We'll zoom out a bit. Maybe I'll rotate it so it's not totally in your arm. Pull it out a little bit. Okay, now let's try to simulate and see what happens. Okay, cool. Okay, I'm gonna stop it right there. Then what I want to do is I kind of want to strengthen it for fun, and maybe I will actually go in and sew the shoulders now. So I'm going to go ahead and do, for the sewing tool, I'm going to do the free sewing because I know we have that dart in the back. I'm going to start the neckline and just sew right there, and I'm not even going to sew the flange part. Oops, did I do that right? Oh, no, not free sewing. I need the M to N. There we are. Let's try that again. Click, click. Okay, that's gonna be one half of the seam. So I'm done. This will be like M, as they call it. I'll hit return. And then now for the other half, I'm gonna click, 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 and now I can hit enter. Okay, simulate that. Okay, so I basically have it. Maybe there's a couple of housekeeping things I can do to make it a little sharper. For example, I think I would like to, sew those two internal lines, like this guy and this guy, so it really pops that they're together, and then maybe I can undo it later. So I'm going to go click and click. Let's do space bar. So yeah, that kind of really flattened it there. I can take off the unstrengthening. I don't need to have it strengthened anymore, probably. But yeah. There we go. Oh, maybe I'll unfreeze you in the back. Oh, dear. Okay. Let's unfreeze this guy. Give it another little simulation. Okay. And there we go. We have a flange. So now figure two does add a little dart. So we can do that next or during class if you guys want to see how to do that one. But at least go ahead and give the first one a try. I think it's pretty simple. There are some more complicated ones I definitely want to play around with. Let me see here. On the challenge, like this one looks so much fun. So maybe if I have time, I'll make some videos for that. But go ahead and give this flange a try. If you guys want to try one of the more complicated ones, I hope you do. Anyways, reach out if you guys have questions. And that's the end of this video.